Greetings, dear friends. I present to your attention the most common malfunctions and breakdowns that occur on the BMW X3 E83. We will not discuss the design, I can only express the opinion that it is too simple. But it should be noted that this had little effect on the quality. The differences in the quality of the X3 and X5 colors, if there were, are minimal. The choice of colors is large, but traditionally black and silver are in the lead, in which the car doesn't look the most advantageous. Corrosion on the body is rarely visible, only in very advanced cases, but nevertheless it is almost always here. You just need to remove the plastic linings and panels, so the inspection must be carried out extremely carefully. Particular attention to the lower edges of the door on the inside and rear arches, as well as the seams in the engine compartment, cups and seams on the inside of the wheel arches. The rear door is the first to rent, but it is usually not connected with the general condition of the body in any way, it's just that its design is not very successful. Moisture gets inside and the paint above the license plate niche is prone to flaking. The hood peels off even more, but corrosion in it is less common. But wet floor carpets are a clear sign that there will already be dangerous foci of rye on the bottom and thresholds, and this doesn't add health to the electronics of the car. The cleanliness of the drainage of the hatch must be monitored carefully. The core elements are much less durable than the body itself. Peels off the covering of roof rails, door handles, painted inserts of bumpers, curled aluminum door sills. Cars are especially affected after operation in Moscow, with Lushko-Sobyanin cocktails on the roads. Even copies of the last years of release have many minor damages. The plastic elements of the bottom and wheel arch liners also suffer from dirt and dust. Pay attention to their presence and condition. The price of these elements can be very big. The comparatively soft windshield wipes out on our dusty roads by the age of 5. Don't be surprised if it's replaced. More cunning owners buy used glass from European showdowns. Even if it is more troublesome, but the expert assistance when sailing a car will not look for obvious traces of body repair. But the proverb says that there are no unbeaten BMWs, and this unfortunately is almost true. The body, even on cars of the last years of production, can present surprises of another kind. Door stops are not very durable. They cost a lot. If the doors open tightly, click or squeak, then it is worth going through them in the service without waiting for a complete breakdown. The power window cables get loose and torn, causing the mechanism to jam and burn out the electric motors. This problem can also be solved without replacing the complete assembly. But breakdowns of the trapezium wipers are solved most often by installing an inexpensive Chinese one. It simply has better seals, oddly enough, and the resource is higher. A native part is afraid of water leaks from the frill, which by the way also damaged the cabin filter. The reason is that the designer seems to be using an alternative chemistry. The trapezium console is made of aluminum with a steel axle inserted into it, which rotates in bronze bushings. As you can imagine, the structure simply has no chance of a long and happy life. Electrochemical corrosion in galvanic steam does its dirty work. Either the motor of the wiper simply gets up, or it manages to pull out the rolling of one of the trapezoid consoles from the tube of its frame. The Chinese save copper, there is no bronze bushing in their trapezium, the corrosion hardly manifests itself. Equally successful in the design of the piping of the rear door washer, the tube is led together with the electric harness and regularly cracks at the bends at the driver's feet and behind the rear seat. Of course, the carpet and the wiring harness itself will get wet. The design of the climate control system is also far from perfect. The service life of the interior fan is not higher than that of inexpensive sedans, literally 5 years. And now the engine is noisy and then the fan stops. The damper actuators often fail. In this case, the gear motors can be revived, but the damper itself also breaks down. The price of parts is not too high, from 2 to 4,000 rubles, but the cost of replacement work will be a couple of tens of thousand rubles, so be careful when buying. If the air supply doesn't work somewhere or its temperature doesn't change, then it is worth calibrating and checking what is the cause. The interior workmanship is lower than expected from the BMW brand. Relatively weak door upholstery, not very high quality workmanship of many panels, weak fastening of inserts. All this can greatly spoil the appearance of the interior. Even on new cars, the trunk plastic creaks openly. Yes, initially the salon looks poor, according to connoisseurs. In addition, with age, the interior begins to sound, which becomes the last straw for most owners. Many cars received an unfactory shumka for this very reason. In an attempt to maintain acoustic comfort, the car is hung with layers of noise and vibration insulation. Many interior elements are flogged or pasted with soft materials to eliminate squeaks. When it comes to a variety of electrical problems, the BMW X3 is rather an exception to the rule. Surprisingly, it is almost no troublesome in this respect. Malfunctions inevitably happen, but they are easy to resolve and not even very expensive. Electronic blocks are few and simpler than older models. Therefore, there are fewer customization options and fewer bugs. If you monitor the tightness of the electrical covers in the engine compartment and the equipment is not too rich, that is, there are not many selling equipment, then there are very few failures. Resource problems with radiator fans are solved by noticeably bearings or fan assemblies, since the resource of these elements is usually even greater than the resource of the heater fan. Swollen electromagnetic mirrors are in general a typical problem in our climate, and saloon electrics failures are rare. Most often they complain about the ESP control unit of the driver's side. It is often flooded with water and the structure is not sealed. Heated steering wheel and seats are not very reliable here, and also often lead to skin damage. Sometimes the sensors for the presence of a passenger in the front seats also fails. The headlights do not have good airtightness, but they rarely fail. Besides, there are new glasses on sale, so that everything can be restored. Of the various electronic units in terms of the number of failures, after the multimedia system, this servotronic unit, the power steering, is perhaps the leader. The steering column switch block simply has a limited resource, usually it needs to be replaced every 4 to 5 years, but its price is very low by the standards of the brand. The resource of the electric motor and the gearbox of the transfer case servo is also very small. The gears are corny there, but all these problems are now being solved simply and inexpensively, provided that the correct service is contacted. In this regard, the X3 is generally a role model, including for other BMWs. The brakes are not only perfectly tuned and efficient, but also reliable. Stable long service life of discs and pads, reliable brake lines, strong ABS block. And the price of the original components of the brake system is more than sparing, you don't have to bother with the selection of analogs. The steering is also no surprises. The steering rack is simple and reliable here, except that the power steering force control system from ZF Servotronic fails. The control unit often fails. At the same time, the valve system is still too young for serious failures, and besides, if it breaks down, nothing terrible happens. Drivers often do not even notice that the effort of the steering wheel has become less thoroughbred. Backlash of the rail is found only after a run of 150-200,000 km and is easily eliminated. Rips are very rare and mainly on cars with very wide tires. Steering tips and roads have a resource of at least 80-100,000 km and the price is also relatively low. The suspensions are more reliable than the X5 and passenger's car. The levers are mostly steel, the silent blocks are changed separately, as are the ball joints. The resource strongly depends on the style of operation, but when driving mainly in the city, the suspension is excellently reliable. Except for the interval bar struts, more or less serious work on replacing the lower arms and ball joints can be expected only after hundreds of thousands of kilometers, and the rest of the elements are even more reliable. With runs over 200,000 km, there are cars with native rear suspension components and without backlash. Considering the low price of spare parts, you cannot pay much attention to the condition of the suspension. It only speaks about the styles of maintenance. But the elements of the transmission on the X3 should be given utmost attention. The pre-styling machines distinguish themselves by the frankly small resource of the cardan shafts, especially the front one. The design of the shaft was shaken, and on cars after 2006, there is a cover that covers the rear cross piece of the front shaft. As a result, its resource has increased, but it still needs to be checked regularly. The casing, by the way, can also be installed on pre-styling models. The worn-out front propeller shaft broke the already weak housing of the pre-styling transfer case. After damage to the bearings and shafts, the entire unit is usually sent straight to the trash heap. So if there are twitchings, vibrations, or even crackling during acceleration, then you should carefully check the backlash of the transfer case in the service. However, it is also possible that the front-wheel drive is not connected at all. I have already mentioned the gearbox drive in the electrical section, but suddenly you didn't pay attention to this? A solid part of the cars has long been rear-wheel drive without alternative. They cannot connect the front axle, since it is almost invisible in city traffic. Previously, the entire servo was changed, but now you can just buy a set of gears and replace it in the service, which is in the order of magnitude cheaper. If you thought that apart from this nothing can be broken, then you are mistaken. The rear gearbox on cars with 3-liter diesels and gasoline engines is also at risk. If you miss the oil level in it, then it will die quickly, but even without this, it sometimes cuts off the gears of the differential satellites and damages the bearings. And often the repair is no longer possible, only replacement. But with the machines here, everything is a little more complicated. Before installing in 2006, almost all cars were equipped with 5-speed gearboxes produced by GM of the 5 L40E series. But in short, the design of the box doesn't like high engine speeds, dirty oil and overheating. doesn't withstand the pedal pump, the gas turbine engine blocking linings, PWM solenoids and plastic washers. If you change the oil frequently, the gearbox performs well. The resource is more than 250,000 km before the first bulkhead with a replacement of the gas turbine engine linings and the drive clutch package. But in case of overheating, the repair is quite large-scale and complex. Those who operate the car carefully and do not like to drive, the automatic transmission is usually in a very good condition, even despite the age and mileage. But there are not many of these among BMW owners. The diesel engine 3.0 with a capacity of 215 horsepower has already been equipped with a new automatic transmission ZF 6 HP 26 series since 2005. The same box has been used for diesel 3.0 engines after restyling and a 3-liter 272 horsepower gasoline engines. This box already withstands the temperament of the driver noticeably better, but due to the peculiarities of its work, it has a small resource of the gas turbine engine linings, which even with quiet movement rarely exceeds 120-150,000 km, and in the future, the rate of contamination of the box oil sharply increases. The weld body of the box was first combined with control electronics and received the name Mechatronic, which has since become synonymous with terrible troubles with the box. Early versions of automatic transmission suffered from many childhood diseases, mainly associated with the valve body, its overheating and pollution. The main problems of this automatic transmission are associated with the untimely repair of the gas turbine engine, failures of the same mechatronics and vibrations of the shaft due to an increase in the clearance of the bare bushings and a drop in pressure. With frequent oil changes and a neat driving style, the box has quite a decent resource, but for most drivers it will require repairs even with runs of 150,000 km, and if you tighten it, then the extra 40-50,000 km can be expensive, and the repair will become golden. Boxes of the ZF 6 HP19 series, which were installed on restyled cars with 2.0 diesel and gasoline engines, in fact they did not differ from 6 HP26. There are the same problems, the same features in repair, except that there are fewer childhood diseases and the resource of the gas turbine engine is slightly higher. On engines of 2.5 liters and some 3.0 after restyling, there is also a 6-speed from GM of the 6L45 series. It has a lot of childhood diseases. In particular, until 2008, there was a problem with the oil pump cover, which led to the progressive wear of the clutch packs. The initial stage manifests itself in the form of jerks when switching from second to third gear, and if tightened with repairs, jerks appear when switching 3-5. A similar problem occurs with another factory defect, a crack in the S55 drum. The gas turbine engine breaks down here not only due to wear of the blocking linings, its hub many also fail. However, the resource of the linings is also very low when driving aggressively. Like the 5-speed ancestor, the gearbox doesn't like the aggressive driving, but in the vegetable mode the safety factor of the structure lasts for a long time, and it is still noticeably easier to repair than the 6-speed ZF, and even cheaper. In addition, the choice of contract units is higher. These boxes were massively installed overseas on Ford and GM cars, so we can purchase factory restoration units even with a guarantee. Before styling, cars were equipped with either a full and unsuccessful 4 of the N46B20 series or very good 6s of the M54 series. The 4-cylinder engine is not only weak, but also completely unnecessarily overcomplicated. It has a fragile electronic throttle-free intake system, a very high operating temperature, a sluggish nature, and a high probability of leaks, all losses and failures of VANOS phase shifters. It is strongly not recommended to purchase. Fuel consumption with this engine is still not lower than that of 3-liter 6, and repairs will eat up much more, and you still have to spend money on oil. More powerful motors of the M54 series are presented in two versions, with a volume of 2.5 and 3.0 liters. They were a little simpler, noticeably more powerful and more resourceful. They were one of the last millionaires at BMW. They are able in most cases to cover 300-500,000 km before serious repairs, although they require regular maintenance. It will also require elimination of leaks and work with the crankcase ventilation system, and restoration of rubber seals, as well as replacement of plastic elements on the intake system, engine housing and oil system. With slight overheating, the motors acquired an oily appetite due to caulking of the rings, which can be cured at the initial stages by decaulking or replacing the rings. In winter and in cold oil, motors tend to drop in compression due to the not very successful design of hydraulic compensators. With active movement, the oil pump or its chain can fail, and the oil filter glass is extremely vulnerable and suffers from leaks. The Siemens control system is also far from problem-free, but in general, these are the most successful motors for the X3. Traditionally, cooling system is necessary to carefully monitor. keep wind radiators, fans serviceable, oil change often, and pouring good PAO based rather than the original. It usually doesn't make sense to change the cap of the expansion tank, but the part is inexpensive. If the service insists, change it. It won't get any worse. All gasoline engines easily damage catalyst when oil consumption starts from 300 grams per 1000 kilometers over time, and at a consumption per liter per 1000 catalysts die in just a year. Diesel engines before restyling are variations of the excellent 3-liter M57. It was also installed after restyling, but in slightly modified modifications. This inline 6 on the X3 turned out to be the most powerful engine. The top-end version with turbines developed 286 horsepower, which is more than any of the gasoline engines. The bulk of diesel engines are options for 218 liters, which are not very different from it. The motors can be considered even more successful than the M54 gasoline series. Stable resource over 300, no tendency to overheat and no appetite for oil, very good traction and economy. Of course, there are also disadvantages. The same oil leaks, the same problems with the oil pump, the plastic glass of the oil filter, it is just as sensitive to cooling system failures as in the M54. Plus, it doesn't have the most reliable thermostat, not a very large radiator area, and the reliability of the cooling system fans. It is worth watching the crankshaft pulley with a damper, it is prone to delamination, and the integrity of the exhaust manifold. The latter often cracks, the fragments damage the turbine, and if very unlucky, then the piston group. Typical diesel illness were not without. Injection pumps and injectors are sensitive to fuel quality, glow plugs are not reliable and can also damage the glow control unit. The EGR well requires prophylaxis every 50-60,000 km. Variable geometry turbine also requires cleaning and control system adjustments. In the case of chipped tuning, the permissible combustion temperature is often exceeded. As a result, the cylinder head resource is sharply reduced, cracks appear in it, lack valves and pistons. If the control software is not standard, then check the tightness of the cooling system, whether exhaust gases erupt through the cracks in the cylinder head. Younger diesels with a volume of 2.0 liters before installing are represented by the M57 TUD20 series, which is also very successful. Of the series problems, frequent failures of the ECU motor are noted. Otherwise, a reduced copy of the M57, exactly the same features and difficulties, adjusted for a decrease in the number of cylinders. The timing resource is often less than 150-180,000 km, but the chain is traditionally located here, on the front wall of the engine, and replacement is not particularly difficult. After restyling, the number of successful engines has significantly diminished. The quite successful M54 series was replaced by the much more problematic and complex M52, and the M47 diesels were replaced by the N47 and Alusil, which differ from them in design not for the better. And all the motors had enough childhood diseases. The inline 6's N52 only at first glance looks similar to the classic. The main differences in the presence of throttleness, valvetronic 2 intake, and cooling system with an electric pump, and a noticeably higher operating temperature. The cylinder block is cast from magnesium alloy, with cylinder liners using Alusil technology. In addition to all the problems of predecessors, new ones were added. The tendency to coke has increased, especially in the 2.5-liter version. It has a frankly unsuccessful piston group. 3.0 engines in this regard are only slightly worse than their predecessors. Do not look for an oil dipstick. These motors have an electronics level sensor and it sometimes fails, which in combination with an oil appetite very often leads to engine failure. Cooling system failures are now more common. Higher nominal temperatures contribute to early aging of rubber hoses and plastic parts, and the electric pump is less reliable than the classic bell-driven design. The block is less rigid, and the Alusil coating no longer tolerates the loss of mobility of the piston rings and is easily damaged, in contrast to the cast iron liners of its predecessor. Therefore, any oil eater requires immediate elimination. Leave the statement BMW always eat oil for the collection of fairy tales. Stable waste of more than 200-300 grams per 1000 km indicates the need for urgent intervention. At the same time, the loss of oil through the valve seals and the ventilation system is much greater. The rubber elements age quickly due to the high temperature, they need to be changed literally every 3 years. Easy tuning with the thermostat change and ECU reset to a lower operating temperature can help, but the noticeably smaller piston safety margin still makes these motors a much more risky purchase. A restyled 2.5 engine should be abandoned altogether. Without replacing the piston group, it is in principle not capable of normal operation. After 100-120,000 km, it is almost always a candidate for overhaul with an oil consumption of more than a liter per 1000 km. Problems with catalyst are aggravated, moreover, a damaged catalyst is able to finish off the delicate Alusil of its cylinders. The new diesel engines of the N47 series also made us happy. Here the problems are of a completely different nature. The timing design let down. The chain has been moved to the flywheel side, requiring the engine to be removed for replacement. But the unit was poorly calculated, and its resource turned out to be obscenely low. The chain began to chirp and even slip during runs up to 101,500 kilometers, and sometimes didn't reach 70. The consequences of jumping are the most severe, up to the separation of the valve plates and the destruction of the motor. If you buy a car with such an engine, then check if work was done to replace the timing belt. They cost very inhumane, more than 100,000 rubles. The changed part of the unit have a resource of more than 150,000 km stably, but they were not installed on the X3 E83 from the factory. The problem was eliminated only in 2011, when the next generation arrived. All hope for repairs often after their release. Be careful with low mileage cars. If we leave the timing outside the brackets, then the rest of the engine is even slightly more reliable than its predecessor, the M47. The fuel equipment works more stable and the power is higher. On this information on the problems on the BMW X3 E83 is exhausted. If you know more or disagree with what you heard, I am waiting for you in the comments.